It's not a bad thing.
Not bad, is it?
Do we have a key? We do.
Hello, good morning, and welcome to White Details. This episode, Terry and I tackle a ceramic grey Aston Martin DB9.
Oh, that didn't work too well.
How are you filming?
Yeah.
Oh, I see, I didn't
mean to. I meant to bloody start. How do I know? Do I have to do that whole thing again?
Yeah.
Just made Terry jump.
Hello, good morning, and welcome to White Details. In this episode, Terry and I tackle a ceramic grey Aston Martin DB9, the vehicle's in for the White Detail.
I knew that's what you meant, I was just pretending to be dim.
Day like today, this thing comes into its own. This is the Race Glaze 14 litre water filter. It's full of resin. It's actually at the point now where it's about ready to be changed. But the idea being, there's not a lot of shade. I could really do with like a canopy coming across. But we worked with what shade we had. But the water filter, the idea being you can use it start to finish through the pressure washer as we have done today, or use it through a final rinse when the vehicle's washed and then walk away. So it's pure water, there's no bad stuff, there's no mineral content, there's nothing that's going to evaporate in water spot on bodywork. The lengthy wash decontamination here, yes, the rest of the car is going to be polished, but it's just a nice system and a nice filter and habit to use, just so the water spot isn't happening on the glass and the wheels and the trim and the water that's going into the engine shuts, that sort of stuff. It's not going to evaporate and leave tide marks everywhere. So Race Glaze water filter information that I have, I'll put below. Car's been washed inside. Okay, we didn't film the two bucket wash, but hopefully you've seen that before by now already. The tar's been removed from the vehicle. Surface tar deposits that have slung down the sides of the car. Now we're onto the clay bar. The clay bar lifts remaining surface contamination. And just from this third of the roof, you can see the yellow tinge, the yellow staining. Definitely a worthwhile procedure on this model. The roof's bad, but the bonnet isn't. Doesn't make sense. Just something's been settled, something's stuck. Clay bar in question. If you've been here before, you wouldn't know. The only clay bar I reach for nowadays is AM Clay, AM Details Clay. A link to this clay bar can be found in the description of the video down below. Funnily enough, actually, at Waxstock, I spoke to a gentleman called Paul. Paul had a black vehicle, and clayed it themselves. Left a hell of a mess with marring, that sort of stuff. The only lubrication AM Clay requires is water, and I've not once had it mar. Now, Paul is trying his hardest with the least pressure on the clay bar as possible, and sent the images through of the vehicle's roof, and left a bit of a mess. It wasn't AM Clay, it was another brand, one I've not had any experience with myself. So AM Clay, I'm sure you'll get on fine. It really is my go-to clay, it's the only one I use. Paint inspection quickly before we start on the bumpers, then do the big panels, so the bonnet and the roof, then down the sides. But plenty to get stuck into. As we look over the vehicle initially, it perhaps obviously from here looks great, it looks well, it's quite a deceiving colour to hide the defects, but there's certainly been some work on this previously already. It's had a bit of paint work that I know about, that the owner of the vehicle knows about. But true to the Aston Martin form, we have a few sort of areas that are exposed to sander marks from the factory. These are areas which typically are intricate areas, difficult to access or polish. Straight away here, using the reflection of the square light, you see it's sort of a deeper clarity and a better colour there. Down the side of the channel of the vent, it's white and hazy. White and hazy, better. White and hazy. This continues on the top of the vent. Under the spotlights, you'll see it in different formations. And the same in there. Then all the way down the edge of the bonnet, the same. Better clarity and colour. Hazy runs all the way down the side to to the top virtually. In the wing, this wing and offside front wing is the wing that's been painted. Down in this crevice in here, it's left very much the same. Hazy bottom corner of the wing there, difficult because it's bloomy on the camera. On the headlight, we spot a masking mark there, the horizontal line going across. That's lacquer overspray, which needs machining off to be improved and removed. Then on this headlight, again, forms of overspray, which you can hear it. So as well as all the sander marks to correct, there are areas where deeper abrasions can be found. A couple of stone chips and bad scratches here. So the booking is, it's in for the white detail. That's a nice edge of sander. Look at that. Okay, so we're looking at the door, this panel. You see the edge where it's been flattened to, and it progressively stops. That's not very nice. That looks okay on the wing, then the door. Completely covered. Another patch down here. When I say patch, I mean sander marks. You can see the cloud in the bottom corner. I've only got two hands and I can't point there. An edge of sander marks down the bottom. Two deep marks on the near side rear wing. And then as we go across, you can see the obvious scratch in the center there, going downwards. Then how it's surrounded by a haze where someone's T-cutted it or compounded it by hand, potentially to remove the one scratch, but in doing so, left it surrounded by hundreds more. And then there's some form just above the scratch there. There's some form of blend mark going on here. Yet to investigate that fully. But even in these lights, if we pull some focus back, you can see there's something not right at this panel. All sorts going on there, so that needs to be investigated. Rear bumper. The obvious swirls and abrasions, then there's a scratch. Spotted these earlier on outside. So around the badge we have a series deeper marks seen. One up top. I'm guessing these are probably induced by previous owners using the paint to close the boot with keys in the hand. Something like that. You never know, it's hard to piece together. Obviously any contact is bad contact and that wants to be avoided. Use the registration plate. Looking very dull and tarnished, this is the underside of the rear valance. This obviously hasn't washed off or any part of the decontamination, so that'll be put and corrected, as will the underside of this vent here. So yeah, initially from a distance it looks well, but you start to investigate, you start to find new puzzle pieces and trying to piece it all together to remove as much of the surface damage which is otherwise robbing the finish and the true clarity hidden beneath. Right, kettle's on. Terry's just finalising the wheels outside, see how he's doing. And then we'll start some polishing. Look at these. Big gold carbon ceramics, and that's nice. Nice little aero piece for the cooling, I'd imagine. Wheel treatments. Following suit with the rest of the car, everything's pretty clean on this. Not a great deal to pick up. There's a few tar deposits here to be shifted. That's not yet been done. But overall, a clean, nice example. Coffee, Terry?
Coffee? Yes.
So bad, and she knows. Yeah, she bites her bottom lip and draws you in. The nails creep up and down your skin. But you want her so bad, and she knows. She says, I know that you want me. I know that you need me. Yeah, I got you caught up. My web and I won't let go. Oh, what if I want you? What if I need you? 'Cause you're all up in my veins.
hits and I won't let go.
What does she want to know? What does she need to know? Can you touch your skin? Put your mind at ease. What does she want to know? What does she need to know?
With the bumpers and these side skirts now complete, the vehicle has been lowered. And Terry's taping up the roof, and I'm just removing the bonnet vent to assist an easier, safer correction. We've been saved for 4 bolts, it's a no-brainer.
Okay, so cutting has started on the bonnet. Look up here, you can see all the sanding marks, the little blebs and the pigtails. Lots of that on this bonnet to chase out. So I've just hit this portion to about here with the 5-inch pad, obviously yet to do the perimeter down the sides. But using the perimeter, look at this reflection on the spotlight. It's looking pretty good, still not perfect. Wait for it, bang. There the existing sander marks, and this has been cut. Not yet with the 3-inch.
And I won't let go. What does she want to do? What does she need to do? Can I touch her skin? Put your mind at ease. What does she want to do? What does she need to do?
This portion down, up, across, round and back, you've just seen the action of the cutting in. However, here look, very quickly, because Terry's itching to start. Zoom. You see how mottled it is still? These DA marks. Kill the brightness there. You can see how ripply it is still, unfinished sander marks. This has had one hit, but as you can see, it's not enough. This is a white detail. It's going to need more.
Just having a bit of a discussion with Terry about the importance of this light, everything, how easy it is to manipulate a paint's finish. Now, I was pretty much going to sign this area off on this bonnet. I've sort of done this top edge here, and now we've moved the light across because Terry's going to work on this half of the roof, so the lights are going around to look down so Terry can look up like so. But look, obviously this edge, it's been 5-inched, it's been 3-inched. You see them left down here? There's a good channel, nowhere near as bad as it was. It just shows that basically looking down with the sun match, the handheld unit, it's sort of a struggle really to sometimes see. So you need to stand back and look down at the light from distance, because if you're too close, it glares and you sort of lose your detail and you can't see. Anyway, yeah, basically. So I've been down the edge again, my little rant earlier, that's now sorted, I'm happy. Which leaves us on this end, which is yet to be touched. So the bloomy haze, as we go up onto the area that has been cut, look at the difference in the clarity and the colour that's revealed. Once this damage is lifted, you've got a much deeper, darker, richer clarity and depth hidden underneath. Time for you to go. Enough on the bonnet, I think. Now look at the difference between the bonnet and the haziness of the white bloomy wing. Whoever decided that this was good enough to leave the Aston Martin approved body shop. Thank you. Mid-morning Tuesday, had a delivery come through. Also one very happy customer with his Focus RS, that's now just left. And we have been sent through a new Roops Mini backing plate. Fantastic service. Those that saw one of the previous episodes, or even was it on an episode, I think it was on Instagram, the hybrid took a nosedive and the little pad snapped, which has left us using the not so little backing plate for the hybrid, which is still versatile and flexible for the most part. Good service. Thank you very much. Door here, there is the cluster of heavy marks. Such a hard color to photograph. You got the tight clusters there on the edge, and this light perhaps a little too bad, but this compared to that, this is white and blooming, this is ceramic gray and shiny. So whoever's left this behind has left us pretty tricky challenges. This is real tight to the fins, and those on the very edge of the door there, they're going to be tricky to safely remove. Detail in the white way. Feels like this pad's too big for the job, so I'm reducing it down to the smaller white. I stay the same, but then I watch it. Pour coffee, sweat, drinking. Every day I'm wishing I'd see you off my feet. Live, update me, bring me up to speed. About you. Got him. Two cutting sets later, then. Hey, my tape. That's alright. What?
Just walk straight into your camera.
No, it was your singing that got me. Two cutting sets later. This edge all the way to the top under the top there is looking good. It's been corrected, it's been removed down into the tight corner and across. But the rest of this area now is going to be cut with the 3-inch after the hybrid work on the edges, and then it's onto the rest of the door. But that is a result. Polishing almost complete. What we've started on the bumpers and the side skirts, the fiddly stuff, seemingly the fiddly stuff, that's finishing that way now. So at least when we finish, we'll be finishing on the bigger panels, and it's sort of a refreshing way to do it. So it's looking sharp. We've had to do multiple chasing sessions on stray little pigtails, chasing sander marks, all that sort of good stuff. Meanwhile, whilst I've been busy on the near side of rear quarter, which I'll show you in a second, as we look down, on the offside quarter, obviously we have the stone guard films. That's two separate pieces, as the panel gap separates it here. But it's actually done its job. It's actually caught something and something's whacked it or abraded it and left a good old scratch and a scuff. No way that can be repaired other than to be replaced. So after a quick conversation and chat with the owner of the vehicle, we've been able to measure up our own template. With the template in place, Terry is able to take this, measure it up, and plot it out tonight on the software, and cut out the SunTech film for replacement tomorrow. Rock and roll. Whilst Terry's busy at the back end removing the old PPF, realise we haven't shown you the latest purchase. Obviously ScanGrip, we've had the whole video on it in the past, the D-Match, the Multi-Match, the Sun-Match, the I-Match, the Match this. But two of us now, there's two detailers, two lots of requirements for light. So this is the ScanGrip Color Match 2 kit. What we have is the Sun-Match 2, We have the pen torch and the iMatch head torch. I've actually been using this for the engine bay again. And then the Multimatch 2, this is the rechargeable unit, so you can use it on the battery or you can use it plugged in like this one here on the tripod. 65, 4500 temperature outputs with a 2500 lumen brightness. And if you're a mobile company, I've actually just popped these back in the containers just for sort of presentation and show purposes. So if you're a mobile outfit, grab this, all the lights you need, off you go. Old PPF has been removed. With Terry's plotting and measurements yesterday, we've been able to customize, as you can see here, the template. And down the sides, a nice curved edge here, similar at the top. So what I'm gonna do is position you here and leave Terry to it. Wednesday, nearing dinner time. One of the very last areas to machine polish. We have, no, it's not. There's the rear reflectors and the rear bumper as well. We'll show you them in a second. They're hazy and tarnished from exhaust carbon deposits. Second to last area to machine polish. The washer jets from the headlights. Can we see all your swirls and your haze? Tiny little details like this. It's nice to show off with. So, we're gonna go with the yellow Rupes polishing pad with a little bit of Nets Cut from Detailing Kingdom, and then we're gonna do this. Bzzz. Currently on speed 2.5, it goes to 5, there's no point in taking it all the way, shouldn't need it. Yep, damage is removed. So now, change the yellow pad.
Can I leave this off you?
No, go for it, mate. I'll shout over it. To the white Rupes finishing pad. Shadows of the stars still remain in my mind. I had to tell myself it's too late to try. Takes my breath away when I realize. Oh, 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 oh. Trying not to think of you, yeah. Only got me missing you more, more and more. And the loneliness ain't no cure. But I was so hungry, but no, 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 no. I got nothing left that's for me. So, speaking of the other area that needs some machine work, I'm sure, earlier on, when we was around the back, yeah. See the rear reflectors. What car was it now? Aston Martin V8 Vantage. I think these were polished up on film, on camera, and I'll flash it up on the screen now, as you can see. But yeah, it's easy to see how tarnished and stained these are. Perhaps I'll have a go by hand first. It's literally sort of just dirt that's bonded onto the finish. Lack of clarity. On both sides. Even without the light, you can see the restored clarity. Good. Polish is complete, and it's time. For some dinner.
I got nothing left that's holding me back no more. Just trying to feel free, but the feeling's too deep. Can't really shake myself.
Back out with the polisher very briefly. We're on the old Makita here. We've got the rotary going. Reason being, if you've seen these videos before, you may have seen this touch in another video, but we have some, not terribly, but we have some tarnished chrome wheel bolts which just needed an extra lick of life. Now, rather than do this by hand, it is quick and easy to make a bit of a polish and rig on the old rotary. Change of plan, everyone, for the smaller backing plate. Give that a good covering. Lock the speed on slow. Lock the speed on slow and away you go. Aston Martin DB9 in ceramic grey, left waiting on collection. Now I think this episode, the footage, it's all a bit sort of sketchy, there's a bit missing here, there's no interior footage. It's been a busy week, various quotations in the week. There was a pick up the Lancia Delta Integrale Evolution 2, was picked up on Thursday, so that was like an hour and a half, what with the tick sheet, the check sheet, checking it all over and receiving another car. It's all sort of adding to the day, and you just need to get sort of keep with your focus on the vehicle, on the detail. So a multi-stage major paint correction, chasing out deep scratches and sander marks and buffer trails and all the abrasions. The paintwork is now pure. The vehicle has covered 16,000 miles, so with the exception of possibility of a slight road rash or scars, is it that blemish, there's the smudge of paint missing on the rear bumper, which does need paint, but other than that, it's the best the vehicle has ever looked. The vehicle leaves wearing multi-stage paint protection, wheel protection inside and out, as well as the brake calipers, full interior treatments, leather and fabric protection. The glass has been coated to act as a rain repeller. Really does look pretty special. I'm actually picking the customer up from the local train station tomorrow. Today is Friday. Got to run around the car now, film the after footage, show some of the details and the intricate bits, the lengths of what we go to in the week. This is now what I need to show off, and this is how we need to brag about the smallest of details and the lowest of locations, which is what the white detail is all about. Hope you've enjoyed. Thanks again for the support and watching today. Actually, it's been an interesting day. There's been a couple of hours this afternoon free. Now, those on Instagram may have seen a sneak preview of this, but finally been planning and prepping for a unit tour video, an actual presentation of this place, the surroundings, the behind the scenes, which was something I tried to plan for, a bit of a special for the 10,000 subscriber mark, which was probably 2 months or so ago now, and it caught up on me. I wasn't expecting it to happen so quick, and I just didn't have the time. But now we plan for it. I'm approaching 14,000, so it might be delayed slightly, the unit tour video. I'm going to edit this one. You're seeing this video before you see the unit tour video, but that's something to keep an eye out for, and hopefully you'll see it soon. So I'm going to run around the car now, grab that after footage. Thanks again for watching. Thanks for the support, and back in action next week on something extremely, extremely very special. Stay tuned.